Hi, I'm Helle. In this video, I will play a solo playthrough of scenario 1 of Robin Hood and the Merry Men. And in this solo game, we need to get up to 130 points to be able to win the game. We have 4 different roads, we have 6 locations. Here on the board, we have 3 locations up here. Some of the locations we have merry men that can go to, and some of the locations we have heroes. We have this board, and there's really a lot going on this board. I will explain what I'm doing as I play the game and each of the locations. So we have this main board. When you set up for the solo version, you will set it up as if you played for 2 players. And I will use the same board as if you play in the normal version. I will just have more guys that can help me, these merry men guys. I have put on this. This is the normal version of the board, where you have 4 hideouts. You would start with 3 if you played the normal version. In the solo version, I have 5 hideouts, and I have 1 covered up, so I can get up to 6. I have 5 traps, 5 barricades. I can build these, and when I build more of those, they will give me some resources. I have some starting resources, tool, wood, and some iron. We have a coin and 2 distraction tokens. And I have 10 merry men, 5 of them in our training ground and 5 of them in our hideouts. And I have all 5 different heroes. I have to choose 1 of each kind. And in the game, I will use 2 at a time, but I will come into that later when we go to the hero phase. Then we have some task cards that can score us points at the end of the game. We will look at those later. And then we have the different resources. The game is played over 5 rounds. We need to try and get a lot of reputation. This is our reputation track. And if we get up to this end, we will score this many points and we can get an extra 5 points. To be able to get up to 130 points, it's important for us to get up to this last level. We also need to send some guys up here, otherwise we won't score anything for our tasks. But that is something we will do at the end of the game, so I will get into that later. Before I start, I will just say how we can lose the game. There's actually a way we can lose the game, so the game will end immediately. And this is the same if you play the semi-co-op version of the game. If we ever run out of money on any of the roads, then we lose the game. And if this track is filled up with guards, if there are 6 guards here, then we would also lose the game. So there are 2 ways we can lose the game as we play the game. And this is the same when you play the semi-co-op version. It is where you have kind of the things you have to work together to make sure not to run out of money and to defend the village from all these guards. But at the end, in the semi-co-op version, the player that has the most points is the winner of the game. And in this solo version, we need to get up to 130 points. But I think we should just start, and I will explain each of the locations as I visit them. First thing, I need to get 6 cards from this deck of cards. On these cards, we have locations, we have actions we can use for these cards. And I will choose one of the cards to start the game. At the start of the game, I have 5 merry men, and I have to use 5 action cards when I want to use each of the merry men. And I have 6 cards, so I have to choose which of the cards I want to play. To place one of my merry men, I have to choose a card to play. And I can choose to play a card where we have these actions. This is an action on the main board. So if I want to use this card, I can play it on my right side of my player board and take this action. It matches this symbol up here. There are 2 ways I can use these cards. I can play them actively on the right side of my board, and I would have to match this symbol, and I can take this action. If there is available hideout, I can place one of my meeple here. I have to place him at the first empty spot, and there can only be 1 at each location. So I have to place him up here. I couldn't place him here. I have to choose this space. And then I get to take this action, because I'm choosing to play this on the right side of my board where this matches. If there had been 2, if there had been 2 guards here, I wouldn't be able to take this action to take and place it here and get this benefit. Then I would have to play this card passively on the left side of my board and place this guy in the main area, and I would only get this reward. And this is the same on all of these six main locations. But there aren't any here, so I can play this actively and get this benefit. And this one, at this location, we can loot the rich. So we will try to loot the rich. And I will get to throw these three skill dice. In the game, you can use these tokens to reroll dice, but you cannot reroll skill dice. Only the hero dice up here will you be able to reroll, not these skill dice. And to succeed here, to loot the rich at the first roll, I can roll three dice and I need one hit. On these, there are shields and there are these. I just need one of those. So I will roll all three dice and I actually rolled three hits. So we succeeded. Now, this ability gives me the possibility to, at one of the rolls, I could now go on, I could add one more die. So I could have rolled with four dice now, but I chose just to roll with three. Because then I can say, instead of just rolling with two at the next, I can roll with three again. I can only use this once on one of my rolls. I can roll up to three times, but it will get harder and harder to succeed, because then I have two dice and I have to have a success. And then if I want to go a third time, I would have to have a success on one die. I could also roll two now and hopefully make it, and then roll two on the last one to use this ability that this card gives me. But I will roll three dice now again, and I did have a success. So now I can choose to say, do I want to take this last chance and roll one die, or do I want to stop? If I roll the die and I do not get a hit, then this guy will go to prison and I will have to pay a penalty. So I think I will stop here. And then we get to loot. This card we will place on this side, on the active side of our board. We can see this match here. If there had been guards and we couldn't place a guy in the hideout, we would have to place the card over here and we would not get this benefit. Then we would only get to take one loot token. We wouldn't get to roll the dice. We would just have received one loot token. Now we will take this loot back and we will draw two tokens because we had two successes. And then we will see what we will get. We will get two coins, one iron and one wood. So that was good. Some of these tokens, they only have one item on them. So here we actually got two money, one iron and one wood. And these we will put back into the bag. The next card I want to play is this card, where I will also match. This is a place where we will be able to get tools. So this symbol we have on the board here. And I can place one merryman on the first space. And I would receive two tools instead of just one. If I had placed him here in the main area, if I played this card passively on my left side, I would just receive one tool. But here in the hideout, I can use this action and get two tools. So we will place this card on our right side and get two tool tokens. So now we have a lot of resources, so we will be able to build some barricades or some traps. So let's see if we don't have any of those kind of cards. And we do have one here. This symbol is a symbol for the trap. On the board, we can see we can build barricades. This is this symbol, and traps is this symbol. So you have the six different locations on the board and what it costs to build a trap at those locations. And this is for barricades. There are four roads where we can build barricades. And with this card, we can get a discount of one, so we can pay one less resource when we use this card. So for this icon, we can place our here, and then we can choose to build over here. That was the icon we had. So let's see what we want to build. Building traps is also a way we can protect our merry men. So we might want to build a trap at this location or at this location. This location would require 2 tool and 1 wood. And we do have a lot of those. And this one would require 3 tool. Oh, maybe we should take and protect this guy up here. And we have a discount of 1. So we can just take 2 tools, pay them. And then we will take 1 trap. It is this one we are building, so we can place the trap here with our guy. You can not place a trap where there are these guards. It has to be an empty space, but there may be a meeple in that space. There can't be more than 1 merry man at each hideout. Now we have 2 of our guys left. I like to build traps at the start of the game, because when we get more traps to the board, we can get more resources at the beginning of each round. And we can use the guys that we trap to buy us something. But we will look at that. Here with this card, we will be able to take the action again, where we can build 1 more trap, or we could build a barricade, but we don't get any discount this time. So I will use this one to build 1 more trap. So we will place a guy up here. I would have liked to build this one, but we don't have 2 tools and 1 wood. I think we'll build one up here where we can use 2 stone and 1 wood. So we will take 2 stone and 1 wood. And then we will take a trap. And this was the armory. So we will build it up here. From now on, at the beginning of the round, we will be able to get 1 resource of our choice. I think for our last card we will choose to play is this card, where we can get some distraction tokens, some wine. So we will place our last meeple at this location here, and we will receive 2 of the distraction tokens. Now that was the end of our merry men's phase. Now we will go to the hero phase. And I have laid down these, so I think it will be a bit easier for you guys to see them. The first thing we will do in the hero phase is draft dice. If you're playing the semi-co-op game, each player would draft 2 dice. But in this solo version, I will get to draft 4 dice and activate 2 of my heroes. There are these carriages on the board and we can attack them. But to attack this purple carriage, I need to get 2 of these dice to be able to attack. That has the same color as the carriage. So these 2, I would need 2 of the orange dice. There are 2 of those, 1 of the bluish and 1 purple pink. If I look at this one, if you look at this quest card, I will get score money. For each money that are left on the west side, on this location, I would score 1 point for each money. So I'm interested in having a lot of coins in this stack. So I would like to protect this area. So perhaps I would want to take 2 of these dice. And I can also use the dice to attack guards. And this guy I might need to protect. And here we would use, we have to use orange or brown dice. So I think I would take 2 of the orange dice also. So I will take these 4 dice. In the merriment phase, if I took this action up here, I would be able to take dice. And I have a limit in the solo version of 6 dice. I can have a max of 6 dice. After I have drafted my dice, then it's time for something bad to happen. We have to draft 1 of these cards. In the normal version, you will play with these villain cards and you will get these activations. There aren't that much happening on these cards as there is on these solo version cards. There's a lot more guys coming in, but I do also control 2 heroes. And in the normal version, each player would have to draft 1 of those cards. But in the solo version, I will draft 1 of these cards. And if we look at this card, then first we have guards that will appear at these spaces. So we will have a guard here, here and here. And then we have the sheriff, he will appear at this space. Then we have carriages that will be activated on the north and on the west side. But let's start with this one. Here I will take three of these guards and place on the icons we saw. So we had one that would go here. And this guy, he's trapped. If I have a trap, then the player will take this one and place on the board, along with the guard. So we have caught one guard. The second place was up here. There we was lucky. We actually got use of both of our traps. So we already caught two guards. And then we would have to place one up here. We placed a guard at these three locations. Then we have to take Prince John. And he will go to the east and collect money. So he will go up here. And for each barricade down the road, he will collect one money. There aren't any, but there is one. There is one on each of the locations, so he will take one money from this stack and put it in the general supply. And then we have the sheriff. He will go to this location where you can get iron. And this is the sheriff. So we will move the sheriff to this location. And when you place him, you will have to take two guards and place here. So one. Now that is filled up, so we don't have room for this last guy. So we will have to place him over here. And if we get six of these guards, we would lose the game immediately. Now we need to activate two roads. We need to activate the north and the west. And we have to activate north first. This carriage will move one space after this barricade. But if there aren't any barricades after it has moved past one barricade, it will move into the city. Or into the castle. And when it moves into the castle, we will place it over here. And when we are playing the solo version or with two players, we will use these two columns, not these two. We have to place it on the first left top, uppermost left spot, which is here. And it will take one coin from this stack and put it into the general supply. And then we would move the west, we will do the same, go past this. If there aren't any barricades, it will go into the castle. And we will place it here, and this time it will take two coins from this stack. And we are not happy about that, because we could score points for this at the end of the game. I could have built a barricade. If I had built a barricade, then the wagon would have moved to here, and it wouldn't have moved any further. Until the next time it would be activated, it would move here, and if there wasn't any barricade here, it would move into the castle. So I could have prevented it if I had built one of these barricades. But I didn't. I did concentrate on the traps. And that was that. That was the bad thing that would happen that kind of makes the game harder for us. Because next time we need to use this location, we can't use it at the moment, not as the main action, because there is a guard in every of these hideouts. So we need to fight off some of the guards to be able to use these hideouts at this location. And another thing, when we need to move our hero, if we want to move our hero into a space where there is one of these villains, then we have to pay a distraction token to go in there. I was about to forget one thing. After I have activated these two, I have to draw a new one. So we have to draw one for north and one for the west. Now, I cannot attack this carriage at the moment because I don't have any blue dice. But I can go up here in the hero phase and exchange dice so I would be able to attack this carriage. And I think I would want to do that. Otherwise, it would take three coins the next time. These wagons will go this way and then up here, here and here. And when all six have been placed, there will be an activation of the wagons. We will see how that will happen, or the carriages. Now I have to choose two heroes to use. This hero is good at the village and fighting the guards there. At the moment we have one guard. She can do it for the cost of one money instead of two money for each guard she will defeat. But I think I will save her for a little later. And then we have Robin Hood. he's good at in the competition where we can get money and breaking people out of prison. He gets to reroll one time per move. And we have the maid Marion. She doesn't have to pay a distraction token when she enters a space with one of the villains. We might want to use her. And Little John, he can go get some new dice or exchange dice for a free action. It doesn't count as his action. With each hero, I will get to move two times and take two actions. And with this one, I can he is good at rerolling on the rows on the south and the north. He may reroll one die one time. Maybe we should take him, the blue, where we get to reroll at south and north. What do we have at the south and the north? Yeah, maybe. I think I will take John, where we can exchange some dice. And I think I will take him also. Yeah, I think I'll use these two guys. I will start with using Little John and go to the armory to exchange some dice. So we'll place them up here, and up here I can choose to exchange dice or I can purchase dice for wood or for iron. I'm not allowed to do both, even though it would have been tempting. But I think I would like... No. I think instead of choosing this guy, I think we'll choose her that doesn't... where she doesn't need any distraction to pay distraction tokens. I think I want her to go up and fight some guards. So I think I will use her as the second one. Because if we look at this space up here, where we have filled with guards all over the space, we will use the orange or the pink dice to be able to fight at this location. And we have orange and pink dice, but I would like to get rid of this carriage down here so we don't lose more money in this space. So I need blue dice. And for a free action, he can exchange dice. So I think I will exchange the two purple dice for these two blue dice. And then for his first move, I will move him down here to fight this carriage. So he will take the two blue dice, roll them, and you just need one success. And we had two successes, so we did fight this wagon. Now I can place this, for the first thing, I earn one reputation. If there had been any barricades here, each owner of the barricade would earn two victory points per barricade, but we didn't have any at the moment. Next thing, I will have to lay this down, and I can place it on any spot. If I place it up here, then I will get two coins and one resource. But I will take up a space where I would only lose one coin in any of these. So that would be pretty bad for me at the kind of... It's better for me to take this one where they would take three coins. Because the next time there would be placed one here, it would take... three coins from the stack. So I can place it here and I will get one coin as a reward. These dice have been used, so I will return them. And then he has one move and one action more. So each hero, they will get two moves and two actions. And of course, they can have their own ability. This one was a special ability he had. He could do that for free. One thing we do need in this game is coins. And I think he will go over here and enter a competition where we can earn coins. At this location, he will get to roll three dice and he just needs one hit. Then we will earn one coin. If he succeeds, he will go to the next level where he will throw three dice, but he needs two successes to get one coin. And then if he succeeds, he can go to the next level where you need, where you use three dice and you need three successes, then you would get two coins. So you can get a max of four coins if you're lucky enough. So at the first level, we will throw three dice. We just got one success, so we earn one coin. And that coin is not taken. We won't lose the coin even though we don't succeed in the next one. And we will not be sent to prison like here where we looted. So we will roll again and we need two successes. We got two successes. So we will get one more coin. And now we need three successes. It can happen, but we need to be lucky. No, just two. So we got two money at that location. Now we will activate Maid Marian. And she doesn't have to pay any resource, any distraction token when she enters a space with a villain. All the other players, they do have to. So we will place her up here. And at this location, we need orange or pink dice to fight a guard. And I can choose to roll both my dice, or I can choose just to roll one die. And I have to have at least one success to defeat the guard. And you can use these tokens, distraction tokens, to reroll one die. So I think she feels lucky. She wants to attack with just one die. Because if she succeeds, she can attack another guard. And you have to point out which guard you want to attack. And she wants to attack this guy up here. So you will just roll the die. She did get a success. You will lose the die. She fought the guard. We will gain one reputation down here. And that is it. If you play with more players and the guard had caught and was about to arrest an opponent's meeple, then you would be able to earn one victory point if you save that meeple and you will get a resource, but not in the solo version. Then she can fight the next one, and she will fight that guy. She missed, so we can use a distraction token, so she can use one distraction token to roll the die again. She will do that. And hopefully she will go better this time. It did. She succeeded. We will remove this guard, gain one reputation, and return this die. If she had failed and we didn't want to pay any more distraction tokens to reroll the die, we would keep the die in our possession. Now she needs to move and do another action. She could move over here and pay two coins to remove this guy, but we do have Barbara Florence that was able to do this for only the cost of one coin, and I want there to be a bit more before we take this action. So she doesn't have any die, so she can't fight anyone. So I think she will join over here at the competition and roll some dice and earn us some money. Wow, she got all three, but she will just advance to the next level. We will receive one coin. So we are getting a lot of money. And she did get two, so we will receive one more coin. So we just need her to make three of those. Then we would get 2 points. Oh, that was close. Well, that was it for our hero phase. Now we did caught two guys here, so I can choose to exchange them for this benefit on this. I can use some of my catch-up guards. I can exchange one for resources. I would also be able to exchange one for 3 points. And I think I will... Oh, there is one where you can get 7 points for 2 and one where you can get 12 points for 3. So maybe I will save them. I will just exchange one of them to get these resources. So I will get two iron and 1 wood. So I will return this guy and take 2 iron and 1 wood. I can use these to build barricades or more traps. And this one is discarded. And we will flip over the next one. Oh, and here we will be able to actually get 12 points if we can capture 2 guards the next round. Or we can exchange for resources. But we have to be lucky if we would be able to capture both. And then we would advance any prisoners to the next level. There are 3 levels, but we don't have any that is caught in the prison. And then we have to return all our merry men and our meeples. We will fill up our hideouts, we will return all of our meeples, and we will take our heroes back, and we will lay them down, like this. In the next round, we cannot choose to activate these heroes we have used in this round, so we have to choose one of the other 3 heroes for the next round. And then we will discard these cards, and then I have to take new cards to my hand. I can choose if I want to discard the card I have and replace it with a new one, but I think I will keep this one. and then I will get 5 new cards. So I will refresh my hand, so I have 6 cards again, as I started with. And I could exchange one, the one I had in my hand, if I wanted to. And we will return the villains to the castle. And we will advance the round marker one space. So we are now ready to start the second round of the game. At the beginning of this round, I need to take one of these resources. I think I will take one more wood. So I have 3 wood tokens. Yeah. And then we're ready to start the new round. I think I will start with this card, where we can go to loot the rich, and she cannot be sent to prison. If she fails, she will not be sent to prison. That is what this icon means. So we will take one meeple over here in the hideout, and we will get to roll 3 dice. Let's see if we can get some loot. We did get a success. Now she can only roll 2 dice if we want to proceed, and I think we want to. We feel lucky. Oh, we were lucky. Now I can draw 2 loot tokens, or I can risk one more. I think I'm happy here. I think I will draw 2 loot tokens from the bag. And this time we just got 1 money and 1 distraction token. Wasn't as lucky as the last time. I would have liked some resources, but we didn't get any. Alright. That was our loot. Then I think I will play this card, where I can get 2 dice. So I will play it up here. So we will play him up here at the hideout and receive 2 dice. I will select 2 dice. I think I will take... Oh, I don't know exactly. I have 1 guy here. So maybe I should take 2 orange dice. I think I will take this card, where I will be able and use this ability where I can build 1 more trap. So I will use this green one. So we'll place 1 meeple up here, and we can build a trap. Oh, could we build one over here? It will cost 2 tool, 1 wood. We only have 1 tool, so we can't use that one. We can build this one over here. We have 2 iron and 1 tool. So we can use these to take 1 more trap and place it over here. So this was this action. And now we have freed up this space so we can be able to get 1 loot the next time in income. And then I think I will play this card, where we will be able to re-roll 1 skill die at this location. So we will play this actively. So we will place 1 meeple here. That was just 1 look space. And we will roll 3 dice, and we need 1 success. We got 1 success. And we can roll again. I think we will do it, because she does have 1 reroll. We need a reroll. Ah, we managed to do it. Otherwise this meeple would go to prison, and we would have to pay a fine. I could go again with 1 die, but I wouldn't have any reroll. But I think I'm satisfied here. So we will get to take 2 loot tokens. And we will get 2 money and 1 tool. And these will be placed back into the bag. Now we have a lot of money now. That's a good thing, because we are going to need them. And I have 1 last thing. Oh, do I want to do that or that? I can build 1 more trap, or I could use this one, where I would get discount. This is a good card also. Now, with this card, I can send an envoy to King Richard, so we will be able to get the points for our task cards. And these will also score points at the end of the game. Or I can build 1 more trap or barricade. I think I would like to build 1 more trap. so we can be close at getting one more meeple. So I think I will use this one, even though I would have liked to use this one also. But I think I will choose that one. So we will take this one, place up here, we will take a trap. And at the moment we have 3 wood and 1 of tool. So I think we need to build... We have to build this one. With 3 wood we can build a trap over here. So we will place a trap up here, with the wood. And we have to pay 3 wood for it. So we will pay all of our wood. And now at income we will get to get one more card. So we will have an extra card. And then we just need to make this one 3 the next time. Then we will get one more meeple over here. And that's a good thing, so we would have one more action. I would have liked to been able to do it now, but I didn't get the cards for it. So we have placed all of our meeples, our merry men, so we will go to the hero phase. And we already have 2 dice, and now I have to take 4 more dice. And we have 2 people here we might need to protect, so I think I will take 2 of these brown dice. Here we'll use orange and brown dice. And maybe we should take 2 of these also, so we take these 2. And then we have to draw our card. And we got this card, so we will have to place 3 guards at these 3 locations. So where did I place? Okay, we have this location. And here we have a guy, so he is trying to arrest our meeple at the hideout. We have to pay a fine now. So I will take 1 of our coins, it just has to be 1 of our possessions, and placed here. We need to go save this guy. And then we have to play a guard up here at the armory, and he will also try to arrest this guy. So we have to pay a coin. Oh, it could also be a resource, or it could be one of the distraction tokens. I will lay them down. I forgot to do so. Might be easier to see them. And then we have the last one. This up here, where we have a trap. We would have liked to have trapped 2, so we would have been able to get 12 points. So this one we will catch. We would have liked one to go down here. Oh, he will come now with the sheriff. Yeah. Didn't see that one. Then we have the sheriff. He will go to this location and we will take 2 meeple or 2 of the guards. We will catch this one and this one will go here. So we caught this guy. So now we have 3 guys, so we can get 12 victory points. It would also have been nice to get some more of these, so we would be able to build a bit more. We need to get some of these barricades out to the track also. We need to build some of these. All right, the last thing. At east and west, there will be activation of the wagons, the carriages. East first, up here. We don't have any barricades, so it will jump past this first one and go into the castle. And it will be placed up here at number 1. So we will take 2 coins from this. And we have to draw a new one. And place up here. And then we have the west. There aren't any. We did defeat the last one, so we will just draw a new wagon. We need to build some barricades in the next round, I think, to protect them. Yeah, that was this card. Then we have to choose 2 of our heroes, and we cannot choose the 2 we used the last time. So we can choose. We didn't get any more over that was over here. I don't think we need her now. We don't have any at the prison, so we actually don't need him. We might need him in the next round. We'll definitely take him. He can reroll once at south and north. So if he kind of attacks any wagons here, he can reroll a die. So I think we will take him. We will start with him. So he's good at rolling at south and north. So it's here with this blue wagon, and he's good at north, which is up here. This is north up here. There's a brown. This one is going low. It only has 3 coins. So if it ended up placing a wagon here, we would lose the game. I think we would need to fight the orange, even though he's not good at that one. But we also need to free these prisoners and get back our money. Oh, maybe he should try that first. I think he will go up here and use an orange die. So we will take an orange die and see if we can fight this guard up here. It was a miss, so we will pay 1 distraction token to reroll the die. No! We will pay 1 more distraction token. Come on. Oh, impossible. I will pay 1 more distraction token. This is not good. Thank you. Third try. Now we rescue this guy. We will go up 1 on the reputation track. We will get our coin back, and he will just be returned to the training ground. And this die is lost. That was his first turn. That was not a good roll by us, I think. Oh, I took the orange die, didn't I? Then I can't go fight that one. Oh dear. That was not good. That was not good. Well, he might as well go over here and fight that guy. I think he will take the brown die then. And he succeeded in the first roll this time. So we will gain a reputation, he will be returned, we get our coin, and we get our meeple back. So we have saved our 2 guys. And he can attack this guy if he want to with another die. I think he will. Will he? Yeah. Or will he? Maybe not. We could save the die. But we also need reputation. I think he will attack. This one will return. He will just attack this guy. And it was a miss. And he won't use the last distraction token. So we will not lose the die when we didn't make a successful hit. That was that hero's 2 turns. So now I have to choose one of these 2. And I think I will take Robin Hood then. I will save her to see if we get more people trapped over here. She's good at this location. She only needs to use 1 coin instead of 2 coins. So we will use Robin Hood. He can fight this carriage down here. He could go up and exchange some dice. He has an ability to he can reroll once at this space, but I think we have a lot of money at the moment. Maybe he should go up and I think we need to fight that orange. I should have used the brown one instead of the orange one. I will go fight. I will go up here and exchange this brown die for orange die. And then he will go over here to fight this, to rob the carriage. And he succeeded. We just need 1 success. So we will lose these 2. We will get this one. This will go up 1 on the reputation track. And we will place him down here to cover up these 3 coins. And we will receive 1 coin. And that was both of his turns. So we are finished with the hero phase. So we will go to the end of a round. So we can use this ransom tile, and I think I will exchange these 3 for 12 victory points, so we can get some victory points. We need to get 130 points. So these go here, and I will just reveal the next one now. So this will be available in the next round, but we can only catch 1 more guy. So we only have 1 left. We only have 1 trap left. Our meeples, they will go home, and we will place them on our board. and our heroes, they will go home. So we will stand these up, which we have used the last round, and these we cannot use for the next round. And the sheriff, he will go home. We will advance to the third round. When I receive cards this round, I will receive one extra card. So I will get 6 cards plus the one I have. I could exchange this one if I wanted to, but I think I will keep this card. We might need some more distraction tokens, since I used a lot of them. We only have one distraction token left. A lot of money and one tool. So I will get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 new cards. So I have 7 cards now. And then I will choose, I think I will take one more tool. And I will take a loot token, and I have received the extra card. And we will draw a loot token. We got one more money. I would have liked some resources. One more money. And we have 2 dice left for the other round. We could use them to send some invoice up here, where it costs 2 dice, 2 money, and 2 resources. If we get the cards for it. Now we have a lot more cards to choose from. I would definitely like to get this last one. Put out the last trap. And we have one here where we have a discount of 1. So I would like that one. Where would we place? I think I would play this first. Oh, wait a minute. I have to see what else we have. Traps. I would like to pay a, make a trap down here. And it would cost 2 and stone. Stone. I don't have a stone card. That's not good. So we can't make anyone down here. I could get 2 stone, but I would have to use 2 passive cards to get 2 stones. Or maybe I could get lucky. If I loot, I could get a stone. I could get wood with these cards. Well, I definitely also need this guy, I think, so I can get some money on the board. I think I will start with collecting some wood. I will use this card where I can collect 2 wood. Oh, we have to discard these cards. Here. I will play this one up here and collect 2 wood. Then I will use this card where I can get a reduced price, make a trap. No, yes, make a trap so I can make the last trap we have. So we will take a meeple up here. And we have to pay 2 resources. I think I will pay 2 wood to make a trap up here at the wood location where I have a guy so we can protect him. So we will place our last trap up here. At the moment when we free up this space, we can remove this one and we can place one more of these merry men over here. So we have one more. We have 6 merry men we can use now. And that is why I wanted to quickly fill up so we could get one more meeple to use during the game. I think we will play this one so we can get some more wood. We need some resources to be able to build. So we will place him here and get 2 more wood. And then it's time to play this card where we can build a barricade with a discount of 1. At the moment we have 2 tools and 2 wood and we do get a discount of 1. So when we want to build, if we want to build to the north, it will cost us 2 wood and 1 money. Here to the east, 2 tool and 1 money. Or we can build to the west. We can't build to the west. We can build down here because to the south. The only one we can't build at the moment is the west. And that was actually where I wanted to build. Maybe I should do another one first. I do have a loot. I think I will do another card first. I think I will use this one first then. So let's just put this one back because we could be lucky. With him, we can loot one extra token. So instead of placing him here, I will place him over here where we can loot. He can loot one extra token and only one to the total number. We still need a success here. We did get a success. Do I want to gamble and roll again? I could now stop and take two loot tokens because he would, as an action, would get an extra. But I think I will gamble. We will go one more time. No! That was not good. He's going to prison and I have to pay a fine. So I will pay a coin and it will go to the sheriff's stash. This is the sheriff's stash. Now, he will go to the first level in the prison. And now we can use the action here to, in the hero phase, to free up the prisoners. But we would need some of these distraction tokens. And I don't have many of them at the moment. Oh dear. And if you succeed over here with freeing up a prisoner, you will be able to loot some of the sheriff's staff. That is what you have over here. All the sheriff's goods he has gotten from people. Oh, that was not good. Absolutely terrible. Sorry, guys. Oh, we might need to use her to get some more wine for the next round. I think we will need to use her. Did I forget to place the meeple? I have forgotten to place one of the meeples. Two at the wood. Oops, I have forgotten to place one up here. There we go. Should have four on the board here. We lay them down here. Like this. And then I think we need to go over here and get some wine because we are going to need wine to be able to free him and maybe we have to reroll some dice. And you cannot reroll the skill dice, only if a hero has a card on action that lets you reroll a die. We will put one over here, there's just one space and we will get two wine tokens. And for my last action, oh, we did build our barricade. And we did build up here. Oh, do I want to build a barricade or do I want to put and send an envoy up here? I think we will build a barricade at east. So I will use this where we have a discount of one. And east requires three tools. We have two tools. So we get a discount and then we had it costs one money. So I will pay two tools, we had a discount, take the first trap, place it at the farthest space down here. You will always start here and go towards the castle. And I will place one coin here, because this will give us points at the end of the game. That was our last card. So now it's the hero phase turn. I think we would like to get rid of this one, so I will take two orange dice. And we have a brown one there. He might be get caught, brown and orange. And we have two guys here. I think I will take the brown dice. And then we will draw a card. Oof, there's a lot getting activated here. First we have to place three guards and we have to place one up here, one in here and then we have up there. So we will trap this guy. He will get caught in our trap. Ooh, we can free our prisoner. We can actually use this guy to get him back so we don't have to fight him. Yeah, we could do that. That is what this means, that we can free a prisoner for a guard. And then we have to move the guy of Gisborne to north. And this is this guy here. He will go to north up here. And if there was a barricade, he would remove the barricade. And if there was a wagon behind the barricade, it would move forward. But if there aren't any barricades, he doesn't do anything. But if he had been put over here, he would have removed this one and it would have been returned to us for end scoring. But luckily, we didn't build here, so he do not remove any. And then we have the sheriff. He will go up here, and place two guards. One here and one here. And then the wagons in south and west will be activated. The carriages south is down here. It will move up here and we have to draw a new one. And this one will be placed here and we have to take two coins from this space. And now because this is filled up, we have to go to the activation of the carriage. And we have to count how many was looted, have been robbed. There are two, so we have to activate two of the spaces on the board. These will be returned to the bag. And we have to activate the one that has the most money and then the second most money. This one has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This one has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. They both have 5. Then it would be the one that has the most barricades. And if that's the case, then it will be the one with the most of these. That is the same. Then I get to choose which one, because they are the same. So I will choose this one to go first. So this will enter city, and we will have to take one coin from this. Then I will draw a new one. And then this one will enter the city. Oof, this is not good. We have to take two coins from this one. And we have to draw a new. And then we have to activate west. This is this one. And this will enter here. We'll draw a new one. And this will take 3 coins. 1, 2. We only have 1 coin left. Oh boy. Do I need to build barricades? I think I do need to build barricades, the next one. And this one is the one that would score us points at the end of the game, and we only have 1 coin left. Oof, this was not good at all. No, that was not really good. Not good at all. Wow. Well, it's the hero phase. What can we do about this? Now I don't have any orange dice. Of course I don't have any. We really need to fight off this one. Or we need to be able to build a barricade here. Good thing we have Little John available now. We can trade dice and it doesn't cost us anything. So I definitely think we are going to use him. Maybe we should use... I think we will use these two. But let's start with her first. And she can go to the places where the villains are without having to pay anything. She doesn't have to pay any of these distraction tokens. We have 3 distraction tokens. We can also go rescuing this guy. But we can use our guy here to rescue him. Well, we didn't have any guys that got caught this time. I think we will use her ability, place her here. She doesn't have to pay anything. So she will attack over here and she will use a purple die. She missed. I will pay 1 distraction token, and she didn't miss this time. So we will go up 1 on this track and then she will attack again. She will get this guy up on the distraction and we will lose the die and also this die. She doesn't want to do anything more there. I think we need to remove some of the carriages. She can move over here. She doesn't have to pay a distraction token and she can fight this carriage. And she did succeed, so she will place it here and we will get 1 coin. And we will get a reputation. And then she's finished with her turn. Then we will take little John, and he can, for a free action, he can exchange dice. And I think he will exchange the two brown dice to the two orange dice. And then he will go down here for his first move and fight this carriage. He did succeed. We didn't have to use any of our distraction tokens. So we can place it here. We will receive one coin. And we can take a resource. I will take a stone. I think we'll take a stone. What does it take to build a barricade here? We need two stone and one tool. So I will take a stone. And these will go over here. And he has one more turn left. He could go here and see if he can free up this guy. I think he will. And when you go here, you can exchange one of these distraction tokens for two dice. And you may use up to three dice to do so. So I have two available, but I think I will take the chance and only use one of them. I'm not allowed to reroll the skill dice. Only if I had used Robin Hood, I would be able to roll a skill die. I will give up this distraction token and get two dice. I just need one hit on the... I need to defeat one guard on level one. If he had been down here on level two, I would need to defeat two guards, and down here three guards. So I just need one success. Woo, we got the success. So we will free him. If we had freed a prisoner of another person, another color, if you're playing the simi, you would earn victory points. You do not earn victory points when you free up your own guys in jail. But you get to loot the sheriff's staff. So we can loot here. At level 1, you can loot 1. At level 2, 2. At level 3, you could loot 3. So I can choose any resource here. I think I will choose a stone. So I can be able to build a trap here. I just need a tool then. And I can take the tool as a free resource. So we did get something out of it. And we freed up our guy, so he wasn't in prison anymore. So I will save this guy. I will not use this. I'll just take this one and move this on around. Next time I will be able to get resources for this guy. There are also somewhere you will be able to get 3 points, but I don't know what the next one is. These guys, they will go back to the castle. These will go home. We will lay them down, and these will stand up. So they can be used in the next round. And we will take our meeples back and we will place them in our hideout. We now have 6 meeples. And we will move the round marker one space. And I will take a tool for my resource. I will have I have to get cards first. I definitely want to keep this card I have in my hand. So I will draw 6 new cards. And then we will take a loot token. So we will get a loot token. A coin. I would have liked some resources. Yes. And our discard cards, we will put them away. Okay, we have 2 rounds left. And let's look at what we can score points for. With this one, for each pair we have made of traps and barricades, we will score 2 victory points. So we need to make some of these barricades if we can to score this. This can give us a max of 10 points if we complete this one. With this one, the location where we have the armory, where we have the dice, for each location that doesn't have a guard, we could score 2 points. At the moment, there are 3 guards here, so we would only score 2 points for that at the moment. And for this one, at west, we will score 1 point for each gold. And at the moment, there are only 1 gold. We can only score for these if we get men up at this location. But I don't think we will make them all, because this one wouldn't give us that many points. So I think I will focus on building these barricades, and perhaps we could remove these guys here, so that could score us points. Oh, we could start getting some money here. When we send a guy up here, we can put 2 money in this at this location. And when we build barricades, we can put 1 coin at any of these road places, so we can get coins in these that way by building barricades and building sending out one of these. These cards, we have one here where we can build a barricade, and we have this one, but we would also like to use this one up here. So I think I will use this action on this card and not the barricade. Here we would be able to build a barricade. So we could build 2 barricades, and we need to get some of these, and we need dice. Oh, there's a lot we need. Each of these, the barricades and the each of the barricades we build and the traps and also the guys we send up here, they will score us points at the end of the game. At the moment we are down here. We need to get this one up at this track to score more points and also to get these 5 points if possible. But we really need to protect this one down here. So let's see, we could use this one. And we get a discount of 1. And we can collect stone and some tool and some dice. Yeah, I think we will start. Oh, but we might also need that one. We need the dice. Yeah, I think we'll save that one. And then I think I will use this one to get 2 wood. So we place this card, go up here and take 2 wood. Then we will build a trap with a discount of 1. And we will take... We want to build it here. And it will cost us west, will cost us 2 stone and 1 tool. But we get a discount of 1, so I will take a tool and the stone. And then we have our coin, and we'll place our coin here. I can choose any road. And then we will place this trap here. Then we could use this one to collect 2 tools. We can place them here. And we will collect 2 tools. And I will use this card to collect 2 dice. We will use this one up here. Just have 1 spot we can go into here. And I will take just 2 blue dice. And then we can use this card to send in an envoy. We can get a discount of 1, either on a resource or on a die. When we build up here, it will cost us 2 dice, 2 coins, and 2 resources. We can get a discount of 1 on one of the things, and I think I will get a discount on the die. So it will cost us 1 guy, we put a guy up here, 1 die, 2 coins, and 2 resources. I will take the 2 tools. And the 2 coins I can place anywhere on any road, and I think at the moment I would like to place them here. And then I will build 1 more barricade. And I don't get any discount. I have 3 wood, or I have 2 wood and 1 of these. So I can build to south, or I can build up here to north. I think I will build at south because we have a wagon here. So I will have to use 2 wood, 1 stone and 1 coin. So a coin, 2 wood and 1 stone, and I will place this one. I will still place it here, and we will take a barricade over to the south side and pay these to the bank. So now we got some more barricades out, and when it's time to get income the next time, then we will receive a coin and 1 a distraction token. And at the end of the game, at the moment, each barricade will score 7 points that we have built, and each trap 6 points, and each of these invoice we have sent out will score us 5 points. We would like to get up to here, so we will be able to score 8, 7 and 6 points for each of them, and to score these 5 points also. So we need to get some more reputation. I forgot to put up the guys up here, so I will just place them. We have used all of our 6 guys now. We have played 6 cards. So we will go to the drafting of new dice. We have that one. So we will get a blue. Here we can use orange. Here we can use green on both these locations where we could have a guy that could get caught by a guard. We might want to try and fight these guys over here. So I think I will take 2 of these and the green die and a brown. So we'll take these dice. And we have a max of 6 dice, so we could only have 1 more die. Then it's the card's turn here. What will happen? 1 down here. So 1 guard here. And 1 over at the wood. Oh, we have 1 that will get caught by the guard. We have to put bribery in. We will put a coin over here. And then we have the last one here at the church. Like this. Then we have the sheriff. He will go up here. And we will place 2 guards. So we could place all the guards. I actually wanted some of them to get overrun so we could get some more guys here, because we can earn victory points by sending these, defeating these guards. But perhaps in the end we will get some so we can risk defeat them and earn victory points. Then we have east and south. East there aren't any, so we need to draw a wagon. Brown carriage. And south, this one will move but be stopped by this barricade. If we hadn't built it, it would have gone to the castle. And then we will draw 1 new one. So this is here where the barricades, they are useful. And that was it on this card. I think we need to save him over here. And we have green and orange. And there didn't come any wagons here. That's a good thing. What do we have here? This one didn't move, so we might want to do something about that one. That was orange and blue. So we need to get some reputation. We need to pick 2 heroes. He's good at fighting at south. We have also, he would be good to use now when we want to fight down at south, perhaps the blue wagon. So we would definitely, I think we'll start by using him. And then we can choose either Robin Hood or Barbara Florence. I think we'll take Robin Hood and hopefully save her for last to get some more victory points. He's good at fighting at south and north, also fighting against robbing the barricades, the carriages. He could actually attack both of them, but then we wouldn't be able to have dice for this, for fighting up here. We need to free this guy over here. I think we will start him over here. And he can reroll a die if that is needed. So he will roll these 2. And it was a success. Because we have this one barricade, we will earn 2 victory points. We haven't really gotten that many victory points. Normally I will get more victory points when I place these and fight them. And sometimes I will place more at the same location. But this one will go up here. And we will get 2 coins and 1 resource. And what resource will I choose? I have 2 wood. When we have to build barricades, I could need a stone. You could use a stone or a wood. I think I will take a stone then. But one thing that happens now is this is getting activated because we have filled it up. So we have to activate three spaces. There are three carriages we have robbed. So these will go back into the bag. And we have to see where is the most money. It is down here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, it has the most. So there aren't any wagons, so we will draw one. Place it here. And the next second most, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. So this one has the second most, so this will be activated. And these two have the same amount of money. So the one that has the most barricades will be activated. And this is this one. So we will move this one forward one space and draw one. That. Now I could attack this one if I want to, or I can save my dice and instead fight some of the guards. Oh, we did forget one thing. We also got a reputation for robbing the barricade, the carriage, for robbing the carriage. I don't think he wants to attack any of the other twos. He will go over here and see if he can defeat this guard. And he will use a orange. Oh, we don't have these colors. I just used the dice. I don't think he will go over there then. We just used the green dice, or the blue dice, I mean. They will go over here. I think he will instead go over here and fight this guard up here. And he will use a orange die. Do I want to use my distraction token? I only have one distraction token left. I will use it. We managed to defeat one. And we will get a reputation. I will go for the next one. We will lose this die. We managed the first time. We will get a reputation. And he can't use the brown die over here, so he will stop. He can't do any more. And then I will choose Robin Hood for my next guy. And he can reroll at prison and at the combat zone. But I don't think we will combat with him this time. I think he will go over here first, and he will either exchange or he will buy some dice. I mean, we really need the resources we have. I think he will just exchange this brown die for a green die, and hopefully he will be lucky. We will go over here, and hopefully, we don't have any distraction tokens, so we need to roll this one. No, we didn't save him. Oh no, not good. Well, at least I get to keep the die. We did not save this guy this time. So, instead, I think Robin Hood, he will go in here and earn some money. I think he will. He can reroll once, one die. So we succeeded the first task, which is one coin for us. Now we need two hits. We did get two hits, so one more coin. And okay, we need three coins and can reroll one die. That ain't gonna help us. So he didn't get any more out of that. That was it. That was not that good. I really wanted to have been able to fight this guy also. Well, it didn't happen. But now you can see what will happen then. He will go to prison at the level 1. And this coin will go to the sheriff staff. Stash. The sheriff's stash of items. we can use this one. I think we need the resources. I think we'll exchange this guy and get 2 wood and 1 tool. So we will take 2 wood and 1 tool. So we have some resources for the next round. I would like to be able to build the last 2 barricades, but I would also like to send 2 men up here if it's possible. And we can't use this last one. He will go home. My heroes will go home. So the heroes here, they will rest. And these 2 will stand up again. So we can use them for the last round. Our meeple. This guy up here, he will stay. We will not remove him. All other guys, they will be removed. Our meeples. Merry men. And we will place them back on our board. We will move the round marker 1 space. And then I will gain 1 coin. I will gain 1 distraction token. I will gain a resource of my choosing. I think I will take 1 of these, stone. Then I will get a loot token and I will get cards. I have 1 card. I think I will keep this card and draw six more cards. And I will draw a loot token. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then. And we will have to draw a loot token. A coin! Oh, 1 more coin. Alrighty. Let's see if we can survive this last round and get some more coins to this one. I would like to use this one and this one. Perhaps get 2 invoices sent up because they will give us points. But I would also like to build 2 traps. And we got a lot of trap cards here. Do we have enough resources? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We have 7 resources at the moment. And we do not have any discount. We need 6 if we want to build both of these. That will cost us 6. Oh, I don't think. And we need 4 resources if we want to build those up there. We might be able to do it. We might. But we can't use this space. Not the action out here. I haven't even placed any cards on my passive side. They would also score us points at the end of the game, but I don't think. Oh, these will be discarded. I actually don't think I will get to place any of the passive cards. We definitely want to use this one, but we would need more dice also. I don't think I can make both of those. No, I can only make 1 more of these. Yeah. So I will go for making 1 of these and building both of my barricades. I think that is what I want to go for. Yeah. And I need 2 resources for that one. 3 and 3. We don't have any discount. No. And we can't use these 2. There are room up at the wood. So I think we will use this one as the first card, so we can collect 2 wood. So we'll place a guy up here and take 2 wood tokens. Let's build a trap with this card. I will use this card to build a trap. Put a meeple up here. And which trap? Where do I want to put? Maybe we should put one here or here. This one in the south requires 2 wood and 1. I have a lot of wood, so I think I will make this one. 2 wood and 1 stone, and then 1 coin. And I will place the coin at this space. And we build the trap here. And I think I will do exactly that 1 more time. think I will use this card. To build a trap. No, to build a barricade. And I will build at the same place again. And use a coin. And place the coin in my stack here. And build the last barricade here. I did free up here that I could draw one more die. But the die is an income phase. I would get an attack die at income phase, but it's a bit too late now. We are in the last round. Did I place my guy up here? I didn't. No, I did. And we have three more left. So I will use this one to send an envoy. King Richard's Crusade. And I have a discount, so I only need one die, two coins, and two resources. So I'll just take the two wood. No, I will take the tool and the wood. So we will send a guy up here. And I can place two coins. I think I'm okay. I think I can just place the two here. We need to get some money here to get money for this one, so we can fulfill. We only get to fulfill two tasks, so I think I'm going for these two tasks. For coins we have at this point, and for completing traps and barricades. Then I will play this card, where we can get loot, so maybe we can get lucky with something. So I will go to this location. There's just one spot. And let's see if we can get lucky. We need one hit, one success. And with this card, we get a plus one loot. We had one success. And I think I will go one more time. Yes. This means that I can get two plus one, so three loot tokens. Let's see what we will get. One coin, one wood, one stone, and one of these, which can be important at the end of the game. Now we have two of those. And a lot of coins. These will go back. And for our last card, we can't go to any. We can't take the main action on any of these locations. None of these one brings us any victory points. Some of them, they do bring one victory point. So I have, for the first time in the game, I have to play the main action instead of taking the hideout action. I have to place a guy on the main board anywhere. Maybe we should just go up and get a die. I think I will do that. You don't have to match the symbols when you take the main action, and you will get this action. And I will just play one of the cards. It doesn't matter. So far in the game, I have placed cards to my right side where I can take the action on the board. And this time, on these two cards I had left, the action places, they are filled up with guards, so I can't take these actions. I can't place a meeple at the hideout. So I have to place a card on this side of the board. Some of the cards, they will bring victory points, but this one doesn't. And now I can place on any of the six locations, I can place one of my meeple. And I will place him here in the main area. And when you place a meeple in the main area, you will get this. Here I will just get to take one die from over here. And if I had used this location, I would just get a loot token. And on the three resource places, you would get one resource. And at this location, you will get one of the distraction tokens. I think I will choose a brown die for this action. When you place cards here on the passive side, you are allowed to have up to six cards here. And I think if you're playing with more players, then you will get more cards down here. But when you're playing solo, I rarely get many cards here. I normally get two or three cards. And this time I only got one. But you can score points. If you have the same kind, you will score points for these. But in this game, I will not score any points for them. Now I have to choose some dice. I will choose one brown dye. And I think I will choose, maybe I need to save one here or here. I would like to get up to the top here, so I need some more reputation. Might be difficult in the last game here. I think I will take two orange, purple dye. So I got five dice. Now we need to draw a villain card. First, we have to place three guards. We have to place one here and one up here. There aren't room, so this guy will go down here. Then we have to place one over here, and there aren't any room, so this guy will go here. If we had three more guards here, then we would lose the game. Then we have Prince John. He will go to east. East is over here, so he will go over here and collect money for each of these barricades. There are one plus this one, two, so he will take two money. There are only one left here. Wow, north and south. Good thing that this didn't activate also, because then we would have lost the game. And we have the sheriff. He will go over here. So he will take two men, and he will try to arrest this guy. We have to pay. I will pay one money for this one, and then we will activate road north and south. So north is up here. There aren't any wagons, so we will draw one from the bag. And south is over here. So we will move this one space, and this one, and draw a new one. So we survived so far. And now we have some guys out here we can defeat and earn some victory points. So maybe we should use Barbara Florence for this end of the game. Now we have one here in prison we could save. He will not advance in the last round, so he will not go down here. Up here he will be minus 1 point. It might be that I will take that minus point, so I instead can fight and earn some victory points. And we need to get 4 reputation. That would be good if we could get that. Now, let's start the round. I think I will start by using her. And she has the special ability that she only needs to use one coin when rescuing in the village. And I will start with taking her and place her in the village here, at this location. And for every 2 coins, you can defeat one of the guards. But she only needs 1 coin, so we can pay 3 coins. And then defeat these 3 guards. So we'll remove the guards. And we'll earn 2 victory points for each guard. That was 3, so 6 points. And then I think I will send it down here to defeat some of these wagons and earn us victory points. We can defeat this one, and we would be able to defeat that one. We have 2 orange dice and we have 2 brown dice. So I think she will start with this one. We got a success. So in this case, there won't be placed anymore. So I will put it up here and take 2 coins and take a resource. I will just take a... What will I take? I will take a metal. And 1 reputation. Important. We received a reputation. And then she can fight this one. And these are lost. And success. We can place it up here again and get 2 coins and 1 resource. So I will take 1 more of these. Oh, one important thing. We will get 2 points for each barricade each time we make a successful attack and a reputation. So we will get 6 points two times, so it's 12 points. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We will go up there. So that's why I was building at the same place, so we could earn some victory points. But it was also risky. If he had arrived and was going to south, then we would have, he would have collected 1, 2, 3, 4 money. And we only had 1, 2, 3, we only had 4 money here, then we would have lost the game. So it's also risky to build that many barricades on the same road. But that was her turn. Then she is finished. Oh, we didn't, we forgot to move, remove that one. Then we have to choose another hero. And I think I will take John. He can, for free action, he can go up in the armory and get weapon dice. So I think I will take Little John. So he can start up here as a free action. That is his ability. We have one die. And we need two more reputation. And we have two distraction tokens left. I don't want to pay a distraction token to him. Or maybe I do. Let's see. We can go down here. This one we can use up there. Let's see. We have three. We have these resources we can trade in for weapons. And if we will go down. This one uses green and that one. I think I will use two metal for two green, bluish dice. Then we have three dice. Do I want more dice? Is that enough? Maybe it is. Depends on how well I will hit with the die. I think I will take one more. So I will take a sword also. Should I take more dice? I can have six, so I could take two more dice. I could take two. We want to get up and get these 5 points, for sure. I think I will take the two brown dice also. For these two. So, we bought 5 dice. So we are up to our max. Now he has his 2 actions, and we have two of these left we can use. So maybe we can save him, but I will not start with him. I will start down here. So I will go down here and start with using a brown die. Should I then use both the dice? I just need two. Yeah, maybe I should try and play safe here, and then we can rescue him also. I'm not going to rescue this guy. No problem. We get one reputation. These are used. Then I will take the risk and move over here, and I have to pay a distraction token. And I think then we will save this guy here. And I will use 2 dice. We succeeded. So we will get a reputation, so we get up to the last level. So that will earn us 5 points at the end of the game. And just for the fun of it, I might as well throw 1 die. And we did have a succeed. We don't get anything other than we can remove it. And we can do it again. And we did succeed again, but we won't go up here, we have them all. If I had defeated him also, I would get the bonus of this. I would get the resource this location brings. So I would get 1 wood if I had defeated the last one. And that's on all of the locations. If you defeat the last guard, you would get a reward. But that was his actions. And we managed, even though we were down at 1 coin at one point at this place, I managed to bring a lot of money to this location. I can remove these cards here. They will not be used. We can bring back our heroes. We can bring back our heroes and our meeples that doesn't score us anything here. I didn't put my guy here. It should have been my guy and not this guy in the prison. That is my dude there. I did put a guard in the prison, not my own dude. Alrighty. Well, I got one. In the last round, normally at the end of a round, you would advance these down to the next level. But at the final round, you do not advance them. If I hadn't rescued him, he would still go into prison at the level, at the first level. We will first score for these, and we have built all the barricades. So we will receive 5 times 8, so 40 points for the barricades. 40 points. We are at 33, so that will be 73 points. So we will go to 23, and we will get this marker. And then we will receive 7 points for each of our traps. So that is 35 points. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 plus 30. That will give us 7. 107. So we will go up to this point and we will turn this over. So we are at 107. And then we will get points for the invoice we have sent up here. And it's 6 points for each, so that will be 12 points. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. We just need 11 more points. Then we will get 5 points for this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we will get points. We can fulfill 2 of these. And I want to choose these 2 to fulfill. And here we will get 2 points for each set, and we made them all, so that will be 10 points. 10 points go up here, and then we have this one for all the coins we have at West. So we will count all the our coins here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So that will bring us 9 points. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then for each free possession which we have, we will score 1 point. So we only have one of these distraction tokens and then a lot of money. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4 points for our possessions. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then we would score points for the cards we have over here, but we only have one card and this card scores 0 points. If we had had this one, then it would score us 1 point, plus for each set you have would score you 3 points. And if you had a set of 3, it would be 3 victory points. Set of 4, it would be 10. And if you had a set of 5, it would be 15 victory points. And then we have for each level in the prisoner, if we are at the first level, minus 1 point, and then minus 2, minus 3, and if you get your prisoner hanged, it would have been minus 4 points. Now, we have one prisoner at level 1, so he will be minus 1 point. And if I had any captured guards here I hadn't used, they would each have been worth 1 point. But that's how you score in the game. A lot of the points will come at the end of the game. And if you're playing the semi-co-op game where you are playing with other players, then if you rescue other players, persons from the other players, merry men from the prisoner, you will earn victory points depending on the level. You would earn 2, 3, or 4 victory points for rescuing other players, merry men. You don't score these points when you play solo. And when you save players from the guards, from being arrested from the guards, you would earn 1 victory point for your opponent's meeples that you save. So we got to fulfill 2 of our 3 missions in this game. And this is the same, kind of a lot of how I played the game in the solo version is the same when you're playing with a lot of players. There will just be more times where you have to play passive cards because these places they have been taken by other players. So you have to play more cards on the passive side of your board. And you can then go for collecting sets, so that would also score you points at the end of the game. But we did win this time, but I did take some risks. I didn't put many money on the other roads locations. And if I had been unlucky, if another card had come out here, West, we have to see if we have the sheriff. Was he? No, not the sheriff. This guy, this. If this card had come out and we had to place little Prince John over here, then he would have collected 4 money and we would have lost the game. Because there was only 4 money and I had 3 barricades plus the one that is here, he would have collected 4 money and we would have lost the game. I do think when I play solo, it's not often that I have some of my meeples that are sent to prison. And if they are, I would normally rescue them from prison. But in this case, I would rather go and earn some more victory points than the one I would lose for having him here. So it was better for me just to leave him. And I needed to get up to here so we could get our 5 victory points. That is a bit more than just the one we would lose here. But there's really a lot going on in this game, and I hope you got a good idea of how the game is played. Thanks for watching.